Hello students, in this session we are going to discuss kingdom planting. So generally kingdom planting includes all eukaryotic autotrophic organisms that are able to make their own food through photosynthesis process. Primarily they contain cellulosic cell wall structure and they also contain all the important cell organelles as eukaryotic cell contain. So kingdom plantae is further divided based on different criteria. So kingdom plantae is divided into cryptogams and phanerogams. So cryptogams, they do not produce seeds. These cryptogams are further classified into algae, bryophyte, pteridophytes. And phanerogams, they bear the seeds. So these are further divided into gymnosperms and angiosperms. So gymnosperms, they bear naked seed. That means seed is not covered by fruit. Angiosperms, these are flowering plants. They bear the seeds and that seeds are covered by fruits. So angiosperms are further classified into monocot and dicot. So based on the number of cotyledons present in their seeds. So let us understand each and everything in detail. So plants, they are classified into cryptogams and phanerogams. Cryptogams, they do not produce seeds. Phanerogams, they will produce the seeds. So cryptogams include algae, those are also known as thallophytes, next bryophytes, pteridophytes. Phanerogams, gymnosperms, they bear naked seeds, and angiosperms. So their seed is covered by fruit. And angiosperms are further classified into monocots and dicots. So let us talk about algae. So this algae can grow in damp, shady places and also in aquatic environment. So algae show simple organization. This algae do not contain leaves, roots, stem. So generally its body is called thallus. It's like a group of cells. There are no specialized structures in the algae. So they contain cellulose, galactans, mannans, calcium carbonate in their cell walls. So they contain cellulose, galactans, mannans and calcium carbonate in their cell walls. So generally they reproduce by vegetatively. So vegetative reproduction is by fragmentation. They can also be reproduced by asexual reproduction. So asexually by spore formation. They can also reproduce by sexual methods. So sexually by gamete formation. So water is required for the fertilization. Water is required for the fertilization. So this algae are the producers in the aquatic environment. So generally these are useful in many manner. For example, chlorella, which is the single cell algae which produce the protein. So this protein is important dietary protein. So some algae can produce agar. So this material is used in preparation of ice creams, preparation of jams, jellies, and it is also used in microbial labs for the production of different kinds of the mediums. So algae, they show simple organization. They do not contain leaves, roots, stem. Generally plant body is the thallus. haploid organism. So they contain cellulose, galactans, mannans, calcium carbonate in their cell walls. So these all are autotrophs. That means they are able to make their own food through photosynthesis. So generally reproduction, they reproduce vegetatively by fragmentation, asexually by spore formation, sexually by gamete formation. So this is all about the algae. Now let us continue with the bryophytes.